like a fool. What's up, heathens? Happy Viking here again with a shot of metal for your punk ass. It's a well-known scientific fact that metal makes everything better. Everything. Shoes? Yes. Boats? Yes. Houses? Yes. Sex? Ooh, lady friend, you better believe it. Pop music? Think I did it again. Surprisingly. Yes, even my mortal enemy pop music can benefit from a heavy metal makeover and become, dare I say it, worth my time. Metal pop covers are awesome. When they're not hilariously inappropriate, as is the case with Children of Bodom's cover of Britney Spears, they are legitimately melodious and can blend seamlessly with metal sensibilities, as is the case with today's shot. The shot for the day is Rasputin, as covered by Turi Saz. Yup, it's that classic disco song about a Russian mystic by a German band with Afro-Caribbean performers, as performed by a Finnish battle metal band that dress up like Vikings, being reviewed by a Danish person living in Canada. How delightfully multicultural. I'll be honest, to me, this is a really strange cover. It's good, don't get me wrong, but it just seems bizarre. Bodom covering Britney is bizarre, yes, but at least it made sense in a wacky, ironic sort of way. This one just seems completely random. Boney M is smooth disco. Turi Saz is bloodthirsty bombast. I just think it's a weird mixture, that's all. Whatever, it doesn't matter. Let's just get to the fun part and watch the darn music video. And so the video starts in a rockin' nightclub where everyone is bumping and grinding and having a quiet, dignified night out. What the fuck? Okay, there's a bar, a dance floor, a disco ball, and a stage for a live band. This is a standard nightclub, so why is everyone just sitting around being all staid and conservative? This ain't a library. They're just sitting quietly in their safe little corners, chatting to the people they brought with them. And if there's anyone on the dance floor, rest assured they're busting the most pathetic groove you've ever seen. And the live band is just some 80s relic dicking around with a Casio. What happened here? Pripyat is more lively than this place. Zone of Alienation looks like the goddamn Viper Room. It's not natural for a nightclub to be so utterly inert. There can be only one explanation. The club has become infested with crusty old white people. Crusty old white people are like the mountain pine beetles of society, but instead of feeding on our nation's forests, the crusty old white person instead feeds on fun and excitement, leaving only shit and boredom in its wake. They are a precarious, nefarious, and not at all hilarious threat to the well-being of cool people everywhere. And here's the worst part. They look just like us. They could be anywhere. Or anyone.
They could even be people you know. They could be your milkmen. They could be your neighbors. They could even be your own family. If you suspect anyone you know of being a crusty old white person or a crusty old white person's sympathizer, call this number and help keep your country strong.
And they've taken this poor, innocent nightclub and turned it into a den of fucking lameness. Who could possibly save it? Motherfucking Turi Saz. Here they come to save the day, strolling in like bloody Varangian cowboys, decked out in fresh furs and war paint, accompanied by the most obnoxious backlight ever. Apparently they just carry that big, bright bastard with them.
Nah, I didn't need those retinas, they'll just grow back.
At least it helps to pierce that ever-present urine-colored haze. Seriously, what's with that? It's weird. Turi Saz hits the stage and, with the help of sweet electric disco, proceeds to turn the crusty white scourge back into a bunch of hip, zesty young people with energy and passion and functioning bladders.
God bless you, fine sirs.
Wait, isn't this the same plot as Death to All But Metal?
Yep, same old chestnut. Cool metal band turns boring people into party animals with the power of rock. It's a well-worn cliche, but metalheads can't seem to get enough of it. But you know, you're not gonna get much out of it. The video essentially boils down to Turi Saz busting into the world's lamest nightclub and getting the colostomy bag and crackers within to throw the motherfucking skank down. There's not really much else to say about the video. It's not new or creative, but hey, what can you do? Sometimes your video just has to be about how goddamn amazing your band is.
But they gotta do something to make this video interesting, right? So, what do you got?
That works. This guy mixes it up.
straight up gangsta, does nothing but speak lyrics, drink champagne, and get his mac on with a bevy of babes that look rather unfortunately like some monstrosities from the Jersey Shore. But still, he is still more man than you can handle, for he is Pimpo del Toro. He's a rare breed of human being. On the surface, he appears to be a Homo sapiens supercilium, better known in the common tongue as a douchebag. But unlike the common douchebag, he handles himself with class and dignity and is actually capable of shutting the fuck up when necessary. Pimpo del Toro is pretty much the star of this video. He's the pulsating, spray-tan, jewelry-clad heart of this video, and I approve of his presence. It helps that he's also pointlessly epic. Check it out. Epic point. Pimpo is just kicking back and dictating that some cool stuff happened. He does this like 10 times throughout the video to no one in particular, like some crazy-ass Roman emperor demanding crazy things, like, I don't know, exotic snow from Mexico. Which raises the question, what's he ordering anyway? I have a few guesses. Let me show you.
Release the hounds.
Release the Kraken!
Wipe this pathetic planet from the face of the galaxy.
Steiny, get me a Danish! Take out the trash!
And so forth. Curse that man and his shining dramatic fingers. Anyway, Pimpo del Toro is the star because he is Rasputin. That's the idea here. That's the intricate symbolism behind his being there. He's the 21st century resurrection of the Mad Monk himself. Rasputin 2 Electric Boogaloo, if you will. Hence the alcohol. And the honeys. And the band of warriors he has at his command that sing about how awesome he is. Seriously, that's what's going on here. The crusty white scourge was ruining his nightclub, so he got his folk metal minions to rock their old knee-high socks off while simultaneously stroking his Olympian ego with a song about his royal conquests. Yeah, he's not as far from douchebag as he thinks he is, but despite his obnoxious and preposterous swagger, he is not living up to his own reputation. The antics of the past Rasputin make the modern ones look like child's play. Disregarding the political mumbo-jumbo that surrounds him, it's fairly easy to admit that Rasputin was one metal son of a bitch. Let's look at the facts. Number 1, epic beard. Hell yeah. Number 2, he ingratiated himself to the Tsar and his family by healing his son, possibly with his epic beard. Number 3, he drank a lot. Number 4, he fucked a lot. Number 5, he was indefucking-structible. He shrugged off cyanide and headshots like they were nothing. Those treacherous nobles had to wrap him up in a rug and drown his ass to finally kill him. Number 6, he used to have a Wikipedia article dedicated to his dick. Seriously, how metal could you get? He was like the Russian Lemmy. So come to think of it, Rasputin should have been metalized a long time ago. I'm surprised no band covered it earlier. I mean, nothing screams heavy metal like a rock and roll mystic made of equal parts vodka and epic beard. Iron bones and stone flesh, anyone? Dirty deeds and drinking and damsel dicking? Hell yeah! Those are all vital components to a heavy metal folk hero a la John Henry, if there ever was one. But it makes me wonder what other pop songs are out there ripe with the same potential for heavy metal brutal battle glory. Let me toss a few out there. Born to Be Alive, some uplifting, adventurous, feel-good music. Imbue it with some Hammerfall and we have ourselves a party. Der Kommissar, inject it with some Vol beat. Major Tom by Peter Schilling? Well, that has Iron Savior written all over it. Bad Romance? I'm tired of bad romance. I want a good romance. And we all know the best romance in the whole fucking galaxy is from fucking Gwar! That would be fun, I think. I don't know, personal conceit. Okay, I've been rambling long enough. It's time for me to give my final thoughts and wrap this thing up. The video feels superfluous. It's a straightforward affair about turning the meek into moshers. It's simple, generic, and I'm not even really sure it needed to be made. The only interesting part was Pimpo del Toro and his ridiculous decadent suaveness, and even then the whole thing is forgettable. But I suppose that isn't what matters. What matters is that Turisaz took Rasputin and turned it into folk metal gold. Gotta give him props for that. Even though I think the video is mediocre and the combination of Turisaz and Boney M doesn't make a whole lot of logical sense to me, it's still a kick-ass song, and I heartily recommend it to anyone looking to bust a serious groove.
Those Russians.
I'm Happy Viking, and thanks for sharing a shot with me. I'll get my pasty white ass back to work on a new video, and I hope to see you again sometime soon.
Far from the sea, a distant landscape, with burning ships and watering
ordinary by night, but the winter was never this time.